Hi everyone, welcome back to the channel. You guys are watching the Saihik Jyoti. In this video, we are going to see love in the general for the sign of Gemini. So watch this video if you're a Gemini, Sun, Moon, Rising, Venus, or if you're dealing with one. Keep in mind, these are general readings, so it may or may not resonate. If it do not resonate, do not try to deliberately fit in. Check in any other placement. If you want to have a personal reading, link is in the description. If you want to follow my Instagram, where I keep on sharing about law of attraction, manifestation, crystals. I have a crystal store where I sell healing crystals. So if you want all of that, then the link is in the description. You can go and give me a follow there. And now let's start the reading of Gemini. And if you don't already know, I'm a Gemini myself, so I'm a Gemini sun. So hey Gemini, so let's see messages for Gemini. Give me the present energy for Gemini, please. What is happening with my gems? Okay, Two of Wands, Gemini, what are you deciding for? It looks like you are standing at crossroads about something, and you feel that this is a very important moment for you to make a decision about something. So maybe you had been prolonging to make a decision, and now finally you are getting that urge that I have to decide something about this. I have to make a decision. I have to do something about it. And you know, we Geminis can really go crazy when things like that happen. So it looks like you are now on the verge of making a decision about something. We will see what it is about, but some of you, it's going to be a career thing. For some of you, it's going to be a relationship thing. For others of you, it's a finance thing. I don't know what it is, but you feel enough is enough, and now I need to decide about it. So that's the kind of energy I am getting out of this Two of Wands card. Okay, yeah, see, you are going towards a new beginning, Gemini. You feel that whatever happened in the past is a past, it's history, and now you're ready to make a new mystery. So some of you, you are also contemplating a new way of making money. So maybe you're starting a new business. For some of you, you're just learning a skill so that you can upgrade yourself. For others of you, you're just looking for a new beginning in love. So for some time now, you were just stuck between two choices or two situations. The two situations could be you waiting for somebody from past to come back, or moving on, or maybe you were stuck between choosing between two different options. But now, finally, as we move in the month of November, which is the season of Scorpio, it's going to be about transformation. So yeah, it's like you are finally taking that leap of faith so that transformation can happen in your life, right? How sometimes when we don't make a decision, we kind of know we need to make a decision and we don't, our life kind of gets stuck, right? So now in the month of November, as we are proceeding towards November, end of October, you are going to get unstuck from your stagnation and you're going to get this new beginning. So yeah, it's beautiful. Some of you, your money is popping, definitely. Something about a financial blessing is coming into your way. King of Swords. Why are you making this decision? This is because somebody is not equally participating with you. So maybe you were doing more than, yeah, and now you're just mirroring back. So remember the two mean bitches story that I told you in the last reading? Yeah, the same story is getting repeated. I see somebody was not making a decision about you, and this person was just trying to give you a cold shoulder, or they were just trying to keep you stuck. You're basically doing it back to them. But you're just giving them a cold shoulder, that's one thing. But on the other side, you're also making a decision to move in your life. You're like, I'm not going to sit here and make a bitch face. I am going to be acting like a bitch to you, but I'm going to move forward with my life. So that's the kind of energy you are having. So you both are mirroring each other. So this is a connection which both of you just come with the same energy. So King of Swords and Queen of Swords. Some of you maybe, you know, when we get the same kind of king and queen in the reading, it shows a soulmate connection. So maybe you were in a soulmate connection or a twin flame or whatever it was, and this connection was kind of put into your life so that you can learn some lesson. All right, maybe it was there to teach you patience, maybe it was there to make you more financially stable. Like how sometimes some people just become laser focused after a separation or something when goes down in their life, they just put all that energy to build their empire and become financially more stable. For some of you, maybe this connection here was just to teach you more self-love, self-worth, to make you grow massively in your career or finance, something about that. All right, so whatever happened with this person going mean on you, going cold on you, this person not giving you the kind of clarity that you always wanted from them, it all happened to teach you a major lesson in life. that no matter what somebody do, or no matter if somebody takes a decision about you or not, your life is not meant to be stopped. All right, so that was the lesson for you, that no matter what happens outside of you, the inside of you should not stop growing. So that's finally something that you've realized, that no matter somebody acknowledges your effort or not, you are going to keep going in life. You're going to grow, you are going to evolve, you're not going to stay stagnant. So finally, as we move out of October, that's something which you have learned, Gemini, and I'm very proud of you for that. Two of Pentacles. Maybe there was a third party situation, maybe that's why this person was not making a decision and you kept on putting with their BS. You were like, okay, no problem, what if this person is a whore right now, this person is going to change in the future, and you know, this person is going to become loyal. And they were not doing it, clearly, right? Some of it was a Gemini, Libra, Aquarius, or a Taurus, Virgo, Capricorn you were dealing with. Finally, you made your mind that no, I cannot wait for this person to choose me over others, or I can't wait for this person to make up their mind. If they are going to sit here not making up their mind, honey, I am going, all right? So you are going, Gemini. Some of you, you were also dealing with two people, maybe, so there were like two options. The one you wanted was not making a decision about you, and the other person was, I don't know what happened between you and the other person. Now finally you're deciding to move forward. I don't know who you're going to choose, but you are finally making a decision, and that's the Judgment card here. The Day of Judgment is here, Gemini. So whatever was getting prolonged for such a long time is finally going to get resolved. And I see you are going to get a sense of direction and a sense of clarity very soon. Okay, what happened in the past between Gemini and their person, please? Some of you also feel that after this episode, you've become very focused, very career-driven, and your career might have really taken off in last, what, say, 8 months or 2 to 8 months. For different people, it's going to be different time, but 2 to 8 months, I feel, has been very significant for you guys in your career, because you have been super, super, super focused. And if you are still not there, then maybe the next coming 2 to 8 months are going to be very significant for you, all right? But yeah, something about a financial blessing is definitely on cards for you, Gemini. Some of you have already experienced this, for others of you, it's going to come in. So what happened between Gemini and the person in the past, please? What was the problem? Four of Cups, yeah. That's what it is. Somebody was just trying to play blame games. This person did everything and then they finally blamed you, right? Like how when two people are in relationship and when everything is going well, even when they fight, they just try to make things happen, right? But when somebody wants to run away from you, they will just start complaining, right? So, as I read a quote on Instagram, it said, when a man wants to leave you, he will complain about everything. And when a woman wants to leave you, or when a woman is kind of done with you, when a man is done with you, he complains about everything. When a woman is done with you, she stops complaining. So that was the energy, all right? So if you are a woman, your guy was complaining constantly. And if you're a man, your woman just went cold on you. So yeah, either of the two happened. I see somebody just went cold. Somebody was not reciprocating. Somebody was just not giving the equal effort. And even when they opened their mouth, they were just all about complaining. Like this person was just playing complaints, blame games and all of that. Also, I see that you tried reaching out to this person multiple times, but it was not respected. It was not reciprocated. And then you were like, fuck it. Let it be. Let me make a decision. Why am I stopping my life from growing? I see that you've become very determined after this episode, for sure. Hierophant. Some of you, maybe this person was married to someone else, or they just told you that their family is not going to agree for you because, you know, you guys are from different cultures, communities. So yeah, something about somebody's culture, family traditions came in between you and this person's relationship. Or maybe this person was married, I don't know. However, what was the case is not important. The point is that this person just started acting mean to you. Like they were just acting like a mean bitch. And then you were like, okay, fine, I'm gonna make my decision and move forward, no problem. So what is the future energy for Gemini, please? Four of Pentacles. Gemini, you've become very guarded. You've become very guarded. You have trust issues. You're looking for fun. I'm not saying that you want to fuck around. No. You're looking for something passionate in your life. You're looking for a new spark in your life. But at the same time, you're very guarded. You have major, major trust issues now. You have developed trust issues because of this thing that happened with you. So it's like you are manifesting a new relationship, but at the same time, you're not trusting it enough, because you have developed your trust issue. So maybe some of you try to initiate conversation with new people, but then you just immediately guard yourself. You're like, no, this person is going to hurt me. You know, that's the problem. That's why it's always like one step forward and two step back. That's the problem. This is something that you really need to take care of. So what's coming towards Gemini next? Knight of Swords. Who is this person rushing in to communicate with you? There is maybe the same person who went cold on you, Gemini, is now rushing in to communicate with you. However, you feel that you kind of know a truth about this person and you're not going to give them a chance. For others of you, you feel that focusing on your own self and winning at life is more important. And you just don't want to go back to this person because you feel you know enough about them and you can't go back. However, this person, somebody is rushing in to communicate. And I think it's the same person who's going cold on you. Yep, see? The same person who was creating drama in your life, unnecessary ego battle, tussles and whatever, this person wants to now talk. But they're still very in and out. All right, Knight of Swords is not a very stable committing. No. This is somebody who just comes in very quickly and then they leave at the same pace. So be very careful. I see multiple options again, Gemini. What are you doing that people are interested in you? Seven of Wands, you're going to block this person. Some of you, this as soon as this person comes, you're going to block them. So maybe you're just waiting for them to come to you so that you can block them. And you know, being a Gemini, I know what this is talking about. So yeah, for some of you, it surely is the case. We have the Ace of Cups and the Seven of Cups. Gemini, you have multiple options when it comes to love, but the problem is that you're very confused and you are also very guarded at the same time. So it's difficult for you to make a choice right now. Some of you, you don't want to make a choice. It's like you are aware that you have a choice, but you don't want to make a choice because you feel that now you just want to be left alone for some time for contemplation to, you know, maybe enjoy your success. You feel that you have been working really hard and now finally universe is, you know, rewarding you with success in your personal life. So now should be the time for you to, you know, kind of enjoy and have fun. So maybe you just want to be left alone. But no matter you want to be left alone or not, Gemini, I see you will be running into a new connection. Some of you, it could be a fire sign or a water sign that's coming towards you. And you're leaving something behind also. And that could be an earth sign or an air sign. So you are aware, yeah. See, you have been manifesting the stable connection for some time. So this is not new for you. Like, you kind of knew that if you're manifesting, universe is going to give it to you anyway. But now you just like, universe, hold on. I just need to spend time by myself. I know you're giving me options, but let me just think upon it. So that's your energy, Gemini. With the Strength card again, some of you, you've become very strong is what I see, Gemini. Some of you also feel that you don't need relationships or you don't need anybody. You kind of ask yourself, do I need a partner? Is it important? Do I really need a partner right now? It's like one side you're manifesting and on the other side you ask yourself things like that. You want somebody, but then you don't know whether you want them right now. So you're like, maybe we can just wait for some time. Gemini, whatever you want to do, you do, but don't try to suppress your emotions because I see you are kind of overburdening yourself with so many things that you feel if I will work continuously or maybe if I will not talk to anybody or maybe if I'll just burden myself with a lot of responsibilities, that'll be like my, you know, getaway from whatever is coming towards me in the relationship aspect. Stop doing that to yourself, all right? Don't try to run away from your blessings, especially don't try to suppress your feelings. If you are having some kind of thoughts, if you want to express something, express it, all right? Don't try to just tell yourself shh every time you want to say something. Don't do that. Okay, what else? I see a blessing coming in for you in your love life. Very strongly, I see that. But you're having, see, Nine of Cups. This is a wish fulfillment, Gemini. And I see you already knew this is going to happen. You know, you have been manifesting this for some time, but now you're not trusting. Or maybe you just want a break from everything. You're like, I just need a break. I'm feeling overwhelmed. See? The Ten of Swords. It's like you were manifesting with the Magician card, but now you're not ready to accept it. So you really need to work upon your anxious energies, Gemini. Some of you also are very careful with people these days. See, Ten of Cups. There's a very beautiful connection coming in towards you, but you're doubting it, Gemini. Some of you, you're also taking your own time because you've become very guarded, as I said, and very evaluating. So it's like you're very carefully seeing where you spend time, who you spend time upon, where you invest your emotions and all of that. So yeah, it's okay if you have that kind of approach, But don't become paranoid. The point is, it's good to be careful, but it's bad to be paranoid, right? So don't be paranoid. I see options coming in, and one of them is really good. Nine of Cups, Ten of Cups. Definitely marriage is on cards for some of you. Or there could be like a wish fulfillment kind of thing. But the problem is, you're just becoming very paranoid. See? So you're just scared. You're like, shall I trust? Shall I not? So stop doing that to yourself. How will you know if you should trust or not? When you will trust, all right? You need to trust to know if you should not, if you should trust or not. So yeah. So it's like you want love, love is showing up for you, you manifested it, things are coming in, but you just want to like kind of take a break from things, or you just want to pause things for some time, or you just want to reflect. So you're very, very careful. And Gemini, since when you became so careful? Because I see Geminis are free spirited, we take risk, we are such go-getters. And now maybe, you know, all of this actually made you this person. Gemini, whatever you've gone through, this has made you so mature. Or maybe, you know, Geminis are always child at heart, but this situation, whatever you went through, it just made you very mature. So now you have become quite evaluating, and you're like, I'll think about it and then I'll make my decision. Some of you, this person might have already proposed you for marriage or whatever, and now you're just thinking, you're like, I'll tell you later on, I need to think. And that's your past blocking you, is what I see. You're just very, very closed off. Ten of Pentacles, Gemini. Gemini and Ten of Swords. See, every ending is a seed of new beginning, Gemini. I see something major, 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 major happened with you. And it was very dreading and it was very painful, I understand. But it was just your blessing so that you can manifest these beautiful new things. So it's like when you're manifesting, make space for things to come into your life and accept it, all right? You have manifested all this goodness, a connection which is so fulfilling. And I also see some sort of monetary blessing coming into your life. You're literally going from Ace of Pentacles here to Ten of Pentacles. So something really good happening in your money situation. But the problem is that you're too paranoid to take a risk. Or you're just too paranoid to believe in your own self. Gemini, stop doubting yourself. You're a fucking Gemini. Everybody believes in you and you don't believe in yourself. Like, what the hell are you telling me? You really need to believe in yourself. See, engagement and chemistry. This is no joke. You definitely have a connection which has a potential to turn into marriage. And there's like a lot of chemistry here. Like chemistry, physics, biology, everything is here, Gemini. All right. But the problem is you're not opening yourself up to this. Or you're just too paranoid. Or you're just very calculating, right? And you're just trying to pause yourself. So, okay, it's fine. It's fine to take a break. It's fine to think, but don't be scared, Gemini. All right? Don't avoid taking a decision just because you're scared. No, don't do that. All right? Take time to breathe. See, you're just overburdening yourself with so many responsibilities, so many tasks. You're avoiding taking a decision because you're just overburdening yourself. Take time to breathe, Gemini. Don't die. All right? Breathe. If you can't breathe, take an oxygen cylinder and breathe. All right? All right, give me a message for Gemini, please. We have two cards. Conclusions are within reach and your hard work is paying off. Yeah, so definitely your hard work is paying off. Whatever you were trying to manifest, whatever you were working hard upon is giving you results. And I see conclusions are within reach. Some of you, the conclusion is that you were waiting for somebody to come with an apology so that you can block them. I don't know what it was. For some of you, it is the case. The person is coming in, and I see you are going to get that clarity and that closing, but don't wait for it. All right, the apology will come in when it is supposed to come, but don't wait for anybody. Don't hold your life for anybody. Don't put your growth on stop, on hold. Don't do that. You don't deserve it, right? You deserve all the happiness, all the growth, and all the abundance that you have been manifesting, and it is coming into your life now. Don't try to block it, right? So that was the reading. Hope this helps and resonate. If it does, make sure you subscribe, like, share, comment. What are you waiting for? Christmas? I will see you very soon in the next video. Till then, you guys take care. Stay safe. Bye.